Howdy doody everybody, welcome to this episode of the Bio Cup Bionicle Inspiration Series coverage, where we of course take a look at some of the mocks from the Bio Cup. We have a little bit of a chat about them, what worked well, what we like, all that jazz. Been a little bit of confusion on my behalf about what round we're on in terms of numbers. For whatever reason, it's been a bit confusing for me, and I keep mixing them up. I guess it's because preliminaries was technically the first round, and then round one was technically round two, all that sort of stuff. But just to clarify, the coverage of the preliminaries is over, and those preliminary rounds are, of course, on elements. Round one is now over, and my coverage of round one is over. That, of course, was on theme fusion mocks. And now we're going to head into covering the round two, which the theme for that is holidays. So essentially you had to make some kind of mock of a holiday that you were assigned. So, you know, like something like Mardi Gras, Festival of Dancing Masks, Independence Day, Chinese New Year, to name some of the holidays that people were assigned. So that's pretty cool. It's a pretty awesome idea. Of course, at the moment, round three has been announced, and I have already done the sort of coverage, quote unquote, for that episode. And well, okay, I technically haven't done the coverage for that episode, but I've at least sort of done one that briefly touches upon some ideas that you could get together for some of the stuff in that round. But for now, in the next few episodes of our BioCup coverage, those guys are going to be on the holiday-inspired mocks. So, without further ado, let's begin. The first mock that we have today is by Grimitor, and is called Death. So his holiday, of course, was Dia de los Muertos. That's what Emma Sayings on YouTube says, if I had to pronounce that, because I don't freaking know. But, if I'm correct, that's the Day of the Dead. So obviously, going off of the Day of the Dead in little holiday thing there, he has, he said he was mainly inspired from the Book of Life, and he's essentially built some sort of representation of death. I think it's pretty awesome. So let's talk a little bit about what makes it so cool. So he's used that Witch Doctor mask. For those of you who remember the really, really awesome Hero Factory set, Witch Doctor, brilliant set, amazing parts, and just a solid build. He's used that mask, which is a skull, and it's actually a really cool mask on its own, but perfect for some sort of death-inspired, kind of almost Grim Reaper-esque kind of mock. Perfect, perfect mask choice, and I definitely recommend using it for something like this if that kind of theme that you're going for is sort of evil or death-like. You know, the mask looks like a skull, it's perfect. It's also really cool to see all these different pieces here that have been used to kind of create the sort of bone skeletal effect, whether it's actual pieces that are bones, or some of these white claws, or you know, pieces that were like this sort of skeletal head there that's been used to kind of form the front bit of the torso there. Various different sort of skeleton pieces, or just pieces in white that look bony. And one of my favorite pieces that he's used here to create that effect is the awesome spider web shooting effect piece that you get with some of the recent Spider-Man sets. I think it's a really brilliant part use, because it kind of almost looks sort of bone-like, almost a bit kind of like some kind of rib cage or something. But, you know, when you actually look at the piece on its own, it's literally just a web. But yet it flows very nicely with everything else here. So that's something that I think is definitely something to think about that this mock does well is, yeah, taking a look at certain pieces and then kind of taking them out of their original context and you know, grouping them with some other parts and then thinking, you know what, maybe this would actually work quite well because, you know, texture-wise, shape-wise, color-wise, or even if I just sort of partner these together, they actually work really well. And so I think that's a really nice touch on this mock's behalf, so that's awesome to see. Something else that's really cool to see is the use of all these different candle pieces throughout the mock. It's something that works surprisingly well with this sort of death concept. You know, you always sort of light a candle to remember someone if they've passed on. And also candles can just be kind of spooky depending on the lighting and, you know, where they are and that sort of thing. So yeah, it's a nice concept that fits well. I've sort of spoken a bit in some of the earlier BioCup coverage stuff where, you know, people have added things into a theme that are kind of, you know, quote-unquote a bit of a stretch from the theme, but yet they fit rather well. You know, like that mock that I mentioned before that uses a sort of naval mine as part of its weapon and it's a water tower. Awesome, you know? So little stuff like that is always really nice to see to help kind of communicate that theme and, you know, take it to different places and interesting places. So I think it's really awesome. And one thing too that I really like about this is how simple but very effective, simply just layering all these cloth pieces here to sort of form most of the body here. I don't imagine that there's a huge amount of structure or of like a frame or whatever underneath the mock, but it still looks really nice, it works really well, and it communicates the theme very nicely. So I think that's always cool. It's definitely a good idea to kind of play around with your capes there, see what you can do. So very nice work. Let's move on to the next mock, which is by King Marshy, and it's called Year of the Pig. There's a lot to love about this mock. And something that I think is really unique is a lot of the system that's been used on here. You know, we take a look at this head design. It's such an effective, very nicely built pig head there. Looks fantastic. Uses some of these crana pieces there on the nose to kind of form the snout. Looks really cool. It's a great use of crana pieces. And I don't know, I don't see people using cranas too much. And here on this mock, we see some fantastic uses for them. I'll cover a bit more of them later, but let's just keep talking about this head here. So much to love about it. Always really cool to see a very nicely well-designed system custom head, because you're able to achieve some fantastic results. I mean, I don't know what you would use Bionicle-wise to create a head like this. It looks awesome. And some of the other awesome system parts here are, well, pretty much just this whole torso here, using this big dish here to form his belly, and some of these Sensei Wu hats there, you know, using those there to form the rest of the body and stuff like that. Some very nice part usages, and it conveys so much personality. It's really well done. I really like it. And look, I don't know exactly what this mock looks like if you were to sort of deconstruct it and stuff, but for the most part, his body could be relatively hollow as well. So that's something to think about. You know, maybe you can get some rather large parts and, you know, layer them in certain ways, and then the underside structural areas can be relatively sparse as long as it holds it together and it, you know, holds its own weight. And yeah, you don't need to use a huge amount of parts, so that's always something to think about. Yeah, that's really cool. So more system parts being used here, some of these flags and other cloth pieces and all sorts of different things to form, well, a lot of what you would sort of more typically see on a mock that, as I forgot to mention, this mock is inspired by the Chinese New Year. It's more specifically the Year of the Pig, and it's just sort of some sort of little kind of Chinese additions and stuff like that. I think it's awesome to see and really helps create a lot of detail, and especially using some of these printed pieces like that adds even more detail. Looks phenomenal. I really like it. So now I talked about those krana uses. We've got here, he's holding up some, I don't know, I saw it as wasabi or some sort of, you know, some sort of meal of some kind that he's about to eat. And that's simply just a krana there placed on two of those lightsaber rod kind of pieces there. Very, very cool. Very effective way to create some chopsticks and a great way to create some food. And there's a whole bunch of other phenomenal food designs here. You know, using a mask as a plate and then adding a bunch of these rakshi krana pieces in there, and even some chicken legs, and then all sorts of other very nicely designed things, like using these new sort of ornate stud pieces there for like dumplings, and these gears and what looks like a shadow leech, all sorts of stuff like that to create really effective, tasty-looking food. I think that's awesome. I think that's some brilliant part usages there, and really captures the kind of Chinese New Year vibe. I think that's awesome. I think that's very effectively done and is such a lovely addition. You know, this mock would look fantastic on its own, but adding that little table there with food and stuff really makes it so much cooler and better. And heck, seeing some of these really clever part usages here for food makes me want to just play around with a bunch of different pieces and make a whole feast for a Bionicle mock. I think that's awesome. I think that's really inspiring for me. I think that's very, very cool. So excellent work, King Marshy. Let's move on to the next mock, which is by Red and is called The Calavera Camareros. Hey, I love this. I think this is a lot of fun. This is also for the Day of the Dead. This is another interpretation of that. Again, some brilliant part usages on here. We actually see some really well-designed instruments, too. I actually had someone who said, oh, Ben, do an episode on instruments. And I was like, I don't know if there's enough instruments to do an episode on, but here's some very nicely designed instruments. Here we got a trumpet. And we got this awesome sort of little guitar lute kind of thing here. Very, very cool. Something that I like about them, and it's something that I would at least use as a starting point if I was making my own instruments, we take a look at kind of what forms sort of the whole structure of these parts. You take a look at the guitar, most of it seems to be built around this big brown lift arm there that sort of forms the middle of the guitar there where the strings would be. So maybe pick up a lift arm or two and then kind of build around that. Yeah, use some rakshi heads like this to kind of form that curved shape that it normally has. It's really effective, really simple. And then we take a look at the trumpet here. Most of it appears to be formed out of some yellow flex tube of some kind, I believe. Could be wrong there, but it looks to be. And then the other pieces there, some system pieces, some cones, some dishes, all sorts of things like that, formed together to kind of link it all together and make the rest of the trumpet there. So yeah, maybe pick up some flex tube, curve it around. You know, some instruments are kind of curvy and weird, and yeah, flex tube seems to be quite appropriate and definitely a good starting point if you're making some kind of instrument. So I think that's something to think about. Very, very cool. Speaking of other really cool things, I really like the feet on these mocks. they use some of these awesome new sort of shoulder armor pieces that we've seen in various construction Star Wars Ultra Build sets, and they look surprisingly awesome for sort of these little little shoe designs here, or skeletal feet, as I suppose they technically are. I just think that's awesome. I think that's really effective and very, very nicely done. Two other things I really like on this, one being the arm and leg designs here, using a lot of these cone pieces here. Now, these are system cone pieces. Some of them are smaller, some of them are larger, but they work really well, kind of, you know, imitating cloth to some degree, and would also be, you know, they're not too parts intensive to use those to create an arm design, and yeah, it just looks good. It looks like cloth. I think it's very effective and very, very cool. And I also really like how he's used these fancy schmancy new shoulder pieces that the Darth Maul CCBS set came with here, and used them very nicely as sort of the waist here on this mock. It flows really well. There's not really any gaps in it. It's just really organic and nice. I really like that. And then one final thing before we finish on this mock. Really cool to see these tank tread pieces there used to make the hats on these mocks. Very, very cool. Absolutely love that. A great part use. And a great way to kind of tie everything together on that hat. Very nice. Very nice. So fantastic work, Red. Let's move on to the bonus mock, which is by Rockmonster2000 and is called the Spirit of Mardi Gras. Of course, the holiday that he had to do was Carnival or Mardi Gras. Something I just quickly want to touch upon. How cool is it that so many fantastic mocks were able to spawn out of such an odd theme of holidays? You know, when I first read that, I was like, whoa, what are people going to do for that? And we've seen some phenomenal stuff from that concept. So it's really interesting how such a simple idea and such a seemingly irrelevant or non-related kind of idea can spawn some fantastic ideas and concepts. Isn't that awesome? Isn't that really cool? So I kind of guess, you know, the learning from that is to just kind of, you know, look around you, pick something completely random and seemingly unrelated, and then see if you can make a mock out of that. You know, it might make you need to kind of think outside the box a little bit here, but, you know, you can see what you can get and see what you can do, and you might come up with some phenomenal stuff like these guys have had. And I'm sure if, you know, some of the holidays that people were assigned, I've never heard of before. So, you know, obviously they would have had to do a little bit of research and they would have found some stuff. So that's always something to think about too, you know. Definitely do some hardcore deep thinking research, because you never know what you might find. Like, for example, it's not Bionicle related, but I think it's still important to discuss. When I quite recently built a mock based off Mandalore, the one of the planets featured in Star Wars The Clone Wars, I did a little bit of research, a little behind the scenes episode. They talked about some of the designs that they used in there were very much inspired directly from the armor that Boba Fett wears, because originally Boba Fett and Jango Fett were meant to be Mandalorians. However, now it's canon that they just stole that armor and they technically aren't from Mandalore. But I'm starting to get into Star Wars and this is a show about Bionicle. Besides the point though, it was very interesting to note that those patterns and shapes were very much what inspired the look for the areas around Mandalore. And also really cool to note that a lot of Cubist inspiration was drawn, you know, from the art style of Cubism. Aspects of that were also kind of played into it. And so when I then built a specific whatever kind of mock I did build, which I haven't posted yet, for the episodes inspired by Mandalore of the Clone Wars, I kept that in mind. I googled some Cubist art. I looked a lot at the armor that you would see on Jango or Boba Fett, and, you know, took a bit of inspiration from that. Some of it was really hard to put into Lego, so, you know, I could have done a little bit better, I'm sure, but it was still something to at least think about and something to keep in mind, even if you don't directly make huge influences towards it. At least kind of putting those images in your head, it's always something to keep the creative juices flowing. It's something to think about. So that's really cool. Anyway, besides the point, let me actually talk about this mock. We see another cool musical instrument. This is a little bit different from the last one we saw. It's much bigger. It uses a lot of macaroni pieces, a few more dishes and cone pieces, and then a bunch of these sort of Technic connector pieces here to make the instrument. And it's really effectively done and looks awesome. I really, really like it. And again, it adds a lot of personality and fun to this mock, which is awesome. Something else I really like is, I guess you could say it's a kind of Jokson style head. I guess he's kind of coined that at this point, but technically kind of another way to describe it is kind of using a bunch of system pieces and all sorts of other, you know, Bionicle parts or whatever, and kind of just playing around with them and creating some really clever piece usages to kind of form a really unique looking head design. And this is really effectively done using these wings and these gold parts there to kind of create this mask and then this big nose here. And then I love as well how he's used these flipper pieces here, some minifigure flippers, to form almost kind of like teeth on the mouth there. It's very, very nicely done, very effective and very cool. So awesome to see some great color blocking there to kind of differentiate the mask from the actual face. I think that's really, really awesome. And speaking of color blocking, something I love about this is the sort of jester kind of mismatched color scheme that he's got here. You know, obviously it appears that sort of most of him is black. That's kind of more his skin color. But when you get to the clothing that he's got on top of it, the sort of jester outfit, it's this purple green looking cloth kind of thing. And it's interesting because as soon as I hear that, I kind of go, wow, you have to kind of combine those two colors, and it kind of has to look all kind of mismatched like you would normally see on a jester of some kind. And that to me sounds quite difficult to be able to kind of make that look effective and not look too messy. But essentially, it kind of looks like what he's done is actually simplifying it in a very nice way, just making it into a pattern. You know, if there is a piece of purple, it needs to be directly next to some bit of green. And that seems to very much be the rule throughout it, and I don't know, logically it makes sense. I don't know, maybe you're listening to this and you're like, but that's so obvious. But I don't know, at least the way I thought of it, I thought that that's something that could potentially fall into being a little too messy or a little too complicated. But it's just that sort of simple rule of just making it a pattern, making it work like it would in the clothing. So that's pretty nice. I think that's really cool. So yeah, a fantastic mock. And I think this very much kind of captures that kind of Mardi Gras atmosphere, kind of like a little cheeky, awesome guy. I don't know, I really like it. I think it's awesome. I think personality-wise, it really conveys the theme as well. So that's really cool. So four fantastic mocks, all inspired by holidays, the theme of round two in the Bio Cup. So stay tuned for a few more episodes where we cover round two of the Bio Cup. We'll be doing two more, and then we'll head on into our coverage of round three when the results come out. Because as of now, of the time I've recorded this, no one has posted anything. But that's good, everyone's hard at work. So happy building to those guys, and happy building to everyone else who is currently watching. Hopefully I've inspired you, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye for now.